Come on! Stop playing games in this way! Why the hurry? Take your time and enjoy the moment. Get some retro components, install some games that immerse you in their world, and finally start having some fun. Actually, this is what I did a while ago. I got my great Pentium 3 Tualatin out of the box, the 1.4 GHz Tualatin, and bless its heart, this CPU was fast in its day and age. A Radeon 9600 XT, and I've had a quality time with some addicting games. And this is what I'm going to share with you right now, so let's start this journey together. If we're talking about atmosphere, you simply can't go wrong with Morrowind. The music, the world design, the freedom that you have in this game are from another era. Get it? Because it's an old game? Bad joke? Okay. Some will say to try and fix the game. And you might end up spending a lot of hours installing a dozen of mods, and after that you're going to play for 2 hours and quit the game. You need to bring Morrowind to 2022. I don't want to do that. I want to go back to 2002 and escape for a while in this gorgeous game. If you want my advice, who doesn't want it, right? Install Morrowind, create a character, and enjoy the game as it was meant to be played. No, I'm not talking about how Nvidia thinks it was meant to be played. But if you're that kind of guy that likes to tinker, there's nothing wrong with that. But try to play the game as it is for a few hours. Then proceed and transform it into whatever you want. At least, you can compare between original and modded. I've heard many people complain about the combat system. Even if you can point your sword exactly towards the enemy and hit him right in the head, the sword won't hit sometimes, because it has a chance to hit. Isn't this awful? An RPG that contains RPG elements? This is the most disgraceful thing that Bethesda have ever done. Please, try to maybe play the game. Reach a character level that is strong enough to not get beaten around the road, and just explore Vardenfell, because Morrowind is not a game. It's an adventure that should give you thrills. The next game is one that I play every year in the winter when it's snowing outside. And every year I enjoy this classic game to the fullest. I can't point my finger exactly to what makes this game so special. Maybe the story of someone that does whatever it takes to get vengeance, knowing that he has nothing left to lose because he lost everything. Maybe it's the tense atmosphere that the game is portraying. Maybe the graphics are made in such a way that you feel like this is not a game, but something real. I don't know. Maybe you can tell me in the comments below what do you think is the thing that makes Max Payne so special. Vice City. 24 karat gold. What's the best GTA game? Who cares? The important thing is what GTA game you enjoy the most. And for me, it's Vice City. Maybe it's the retro 80s style, or maybe the nostalgia. I don't know and I don't care. The game is awesome and I enjoy playing it. This right here is art. And although the setting is not everything in this game, it sure enhances your enjoyment. Actually, one of the things that people often cite when it comes to this game is its setting. Rockstar's attention to detail is simply top-notch in this game. But what about the remaster? Please, don't ruin my day, please. The art design is gorgeous. It's a shame that the map is kind of small. Actually, the only gripe I have with the world of Vice City is the map size. You simply can't get on a bike and roam around on the map for a good chunk of time because the map is small, compared to San Andreas, for example. But there are still many areas to explore, so give it a try, because Vice City is not only a game, it's a phenomenon. The last game on my list is a BioWare classic, and that's Star Wars KOTOR, Knights of the Old Republic. One of my favorite games ever, and I'm sure that from the thousands of you that are going to watch this video, some have the same opinion. First, let me tell you that in some aspects, this game did not age well, and neither did its sequel, KOTOR 2. The control mechanics are stiff, the gameplay feels dated, and the level design is somewhat primitive. But man oh man, this game is awesome. That's why this is one of the games where some mods can do miracles. I've installed some non-gameplay mods, usually graphical mods, and the game looks and feel way better. So have fun with that. You can go to Nexus Mods or install the mods from Steam if you have the game through Steam. Otherwise, the game must be experienced at least once, and not only for its gameplay, although the gameplay is engaging and fun, but for its story, characters and dialogue, which are absolutely sublime. There are branching dialogues, dialogues between the companions, meaningful choices that reverberate throughout the game in many ways. The main character and the companions change, the story somehow goes in different paths, you have alternate endings. Give this video a thumbs up if you've enjoyed it, and let's start a nice conversation about our common passion in the comments below. This was it, guys. Here are 4 games that you can enjoy on a Pentium 3 Tualatin. You'll have double satisfaction. On one side, the satisfaction of playing some amazing games, and on the other side, the satisfaction of playing them on a historic processor.